Hey guys, so today I'm just going to start the video off by saying all the pros and cons for anyone that doesn't want to sit through the whole video. Today I unboxed a MSI MAG341CQ. So the pros are definitely that it's a 34 inch 100 hertz 1440p monitor. You can overclock it easily to 110 hertz. It's got FreeSync, so AMD users rejoice. It's a VA panel, so it could be a pro or con if you like either or. The VA panels have much better, much higher contrast than the IPS panels. The blacks are really nice, and you've got very minimal backlight bleed, as you'll see in the full review. The picture-in-picture mode is great as a second screen. You can use the HDMI or DVI input to create that second screen without having to do it through Windows. The on-screen selectable crosshair is also a pro. There's a bunch of other cons that kind of might keep some people from not purchasing it. It's got no VESA mount, no horizontal vertical adjustment on this. You can get the VESA adapter from MSI. This doesn't have any built-in speakers, so if you're traveling or if you're in an office and you don't want, you know, big clip speakers or something, you'll have to use your own headphones. It's got this crackling noise you'll see in my review when you start it up. Probably goes for about 20 or 30 minutes, and then same thing when you shut it, you know, turn the monitor off, it'll come up. But again, if you've got headphones or music, you won't notice it. The heat, you can really feel the heat coming off of it compared to the IPS. I guess that may be one distinction with the VA panel. It is a little warm. It's not like super hot. You can still touch it, but not like cool to touch. These bezels are a bit thick. I'm sure they could be a little smaller. Again, no USB Type-C. It's 2018. I really wish that was here, but that's okay. Just a few other minor inconveniences. No joystick. You've got your buttons down here. There are about four buttons, so if you're not used to it, it'll get kind of confusing. No idea what this dynamic contrast ratio option is in there, and not really sure what the response time overdrive is. I'll have to look that up. But natively, VA panels are slower in terms of input lag compared to TN or IPS, so definitely gonna get that. But for under $400, this is a really good buy, and for anyone looking to purchase one, I would say definitely go ahead and do it. So if you guys want the full review, just go ahead and keep watching. If not, I thank you for watching, and please subscribe. My future videos will be in this format. I'll give the pros and cons right off the bat so people can just have the too long didn't read version of it. Thanks. Hey guys, what is up? I know it's been a while. I got a little goodie today. What we're gonna be doing today is reviewing these two boxes. Nah, just kidding. Obviously, it's gonna be what's inside the boxes, but check this guy out. I'm gonna be upgrading from my current LG U34UM69G to the MSI. It's called the MAG341CQ. It's the new, well, relatively new, VA panel from MSI. It's curved, 100 hertz. I think it'll overclock to 110, 1440p, and I picked it up for $379 at Micro Center. So let's open this guy up. So open it up. Packaging looks very good for the most part. Obviously, since it's a curved, you can see the curve coming right through here. Let's carefully take it out. Let's see what we have here. We've got the manual and some sort of feet or something, some screws. Now that we've got the tape out, this is a stand. Feels kind of light. It is definitely metal. It's gone to the monitor. All right, so now that it is out, we kind of get an idea of what comes with it in terms of accessories. Give obviously a basic HDMI cable here. This looks like the back portion. Ooh, nice and shiny. Ooh, definitely good quality. Obviously, we mentioned the manual earlier, and they give you a DisplayPort cable, which is nice of them, and of course standard power plug. So let's see the monitor here. Nice. All right, well, you look at that. Here it is in all its curvaceous glory. This is a 1800R curve, so not as extreme as the 1900, which would be nice, but still good. Ugh, terrible thing, and I don't know why they did this, but look, no friggin' vase mount. Like, come on, it's 2018. They should have this by default, but we'll get to that later. Let's get this guy assembled. All right, before we assemble it, let's take a look at the back. Our standard connections, I'm sorry about the shakiness, I'm using like a neck mount for the phone. But, got your DVI and HDMI, DP, DisplayPort, and then, of course, your power cord. I thought they said there was something about a USB Type-C, but I guess not on this. All right, well, no USB Type-C, but we're gonna assemble this guy again. This is just very pretty here, and it just screws right in to the bottom here, and this has one screw holding it in place, and then you've got two screws that are going to go into that. So if you look at the back, it's held on by these two screws here. They're not real heavy duty, as I would call them, but they will get the job done, and there is a washer on them, so let's do that. Alright, so we've got it all screwed in, and it comes with this little clip here. So yeah, looks nice. Sorry about the blurriness. Yeah, the back has a very nice clean look, especially when you put the cover on it. It will look quite nice. But let's just get this guy stood up and take it for a test run. Alright, so now I've got both of the monitors up here side by side, and right off the bat you can obviously see the difference. This is the curved one up here, flat one back there, but this is a VA panel, and actually the finish on it seems a bit more glossy than the LG. This is the LG 34UM69G or B, or I forget what it's called. It's on one of my reviews, links in the description if you want to look at that. Bought that about a year ago, but that's FreeSync. Both of them are actually FreeSync. One thing that's definitely leaning towards a disadvantage of the MSI is, look, there's really no adjustability for height. The LG, I can go up, down, you know, forward, backward. I can definitely tilt it a lot more than the MSI. The MSI one, well, let's see. You can tilt it forward and back, but that's about it. There's not much, much more. So it, you know, again, just because of that adjustment, it just doesn't make any sense to me why they wouldn't put a vase mount. Like, there's no vertical or horizontal adjustment on it. Just, it'll be obviously a little hard getting used to, but it does look nice. So let's turn it on and see how it goes. So got them both plugged in, and of course you can already see, let me minimize this, the difference in color between the two. The one on the LG, it's a little bit cooler. This one's a little warmer, but this one probably hasn't been adjusted. We'll do some tests on it a little bit. But one thing that I noticed is the footprint. This one has a much smaller footprint. The MSI one has a much smaller footprint than the LG. The LG, much larger base here. Also a lot more pronounced. You see the red right here. The MSI, it's subtle. With its polished aluminum. This is a little gimmicky. I don't like all this here. You can obviously take that sticker off, you know, whatever it says, 100 hertz. But right out of the box, I was able to set it up at 110 hertz and, you know, no issues. But yeah, so if you look at the resolution, 1340 by 1440 at 110 hertz. No issues reading that. Only weird part now is I am hearing some crackle. I guess maybe it's the panel warming up. I don't know if you can hear that slight click. Yeah, that maybe that one should have. And it could just be, you know, the panel heating up, just warming up. So, and it's only at the beginning, but you can definitely hear, it's definitely noticeable. As opposed to the IPS, you don't hear any of that. Could also be because this is curved. Never owned a curved monitor before, but we'll have to check that out. I like the joystick. On the LG, it's got nice little joystick. All right, so just running the dead pixel test. So got it on 3440x1440. Doesn't look bad. Do not see anything here. Nope. Went through it earlier. Didn't see anything. Pretty good. Looks like I made it out of that one all right. The backlight bleed. See how bad or good that is. Not really noticeable. I mean, look at the LG. That one definitely noticeable. This one, it's got definitely got the deeper blacks. So in terms of BLB, this one pretty good or just not noticeable. And I guess that's inherent of VA panels, you know, you're going to see less of that with a darker black. So, well, let's see some more tests. So I've just got to messing around with the monitor a bit, and a couple of cool things. If you've got the display port and the HDMI connected, this monitor has something called a picture-in-picture mode. Right now, this is a picture between picture, so you can split it up two ways. Another cool thing that they've got is this crosshair. This is for, you know, FPS gaming. Second button. You can go and scroll through different crosshairs that you would like and just hit enter, and then your monitor will display it. Now, this doesn't affect recordings or anything like that. This is an actual feature on the monitor itself. So going back to the picture-in-picture mode, sorry, kind of went off topic there. If you come down here and you go to picture in picture, you can change the location of it, you can change the size, so you can turn it off. This is on, and then let's see, you can change the source. So if you've got a DVI, you can do that, you can duplicate it, do other things of that nature. So right now it's small, large, medium, and small. I really do miss the joystick on the LG. I'm just annoyed with the buttons, but you get used to them. There are a couple other options in here. So if you go to the image, you can definitely adjust the contrast, gamma, color temperature, which I will once I get a colorimeter. The movie option, it, I guess, gets a little sharper. FPS is more sharp. Real-time strategy, I'm not sure. The eye saver reduces the blue light. This monitor does not have any built-in speakers. So again, if we're looking at the cons right now, no VESA mount, no built-in speakers, very limited adjustability, no height adjustability. It does have that crackling noise start in the startup. Right now it's been on for several hours, so no noise. But I do feel the heat off this VA panel. Like, you can actually feel the heat coming off of it, versus on this LED panel, the IPS panel, it's much cooler. This, I can definitely feel the heat. Also, if you go to a resolution that is not native, you know, if I go down to 1080, then things like the font become less sharp. For example, this is a custom resolution on the LG, and it'll go up to 3440x1440, but everything becomes fuzzy. Here, it's much more crisp, and vice versa. If this goes to 1080, everything becomes nice and crisp. Here, things start to get a little fuzzy. What else? What else about this monitor? Oh yeah, we need to test the response time, so let's do that. On the UFO test, looks like it is pretty smooth. Really don't see too many issues with it. Hey guys, so we are now in Forza Motorsport. Wanted to definitely showcase the monitor in all its glory. So you can obviously see you've got a lot more real estate here. So let's go into the cockpit. You can see right off the bat, you do get a little bit more viewing distance here. I think this is what would be considered your normal 16.9. The 21.9 gives you that little bit extra viewing. And it does, you know, give you a sense of immersion, especially with the curved screen. It's not as pronounced as you'd like it to be, but I think it does a good job. All right, guys, now we are in Jurassic World Evolution. Loading screen looks beautiful. And of course, 1440p definitely looks great too. So you can see in an RTS or simulation type game, it looks very nice. The screen looks very clean. I love having this extra viewing distance, especially in a simulation game. So I play a lot of, Planet Coaster. So Planet Coaster is similar to Jurassic World Evolution, same people, Frontier. And just having the two sides just gives you that extra viewing, you know, lets you see what's going off in the distance, gives you good, I'm trying to think of the word here, just looks cool, all right? Yeah, that's what it is. Damn you, Ceratosaur, you ate my poor little Pachycosaur. I mean, it just looks beautiful. The poor dinosaur done got eated. All right, and the last game we're gonna check out is Overwatch. It's an FPS, kind of like Team Fortress, if anyone has ever played that. Again, this supports widescreen gaming, which is great because a lot of FPSs don't like giving some players the advantage of having that extra real estate. You know, might provide unfair advantage to other people, but I think if you have it and you are a casual gamer, I think it should be fine. This looks good. I actually don't know if it does give you a little extra advantage or not. Let's do that crosshair thing. So right here, you just go to the second button and it will pop up the crosshair. It's a little hard to tell. Let me zoom in just a bit. But yeah, you can see it's got the red crosshair right there. So it's very cool. I think if you're playing like CSGO or something and you're trying to snipe or something of that sort, you can definitely use it. In here, I don't think it matters much because you've got a crosshair already. So yeah, I mean, overall, I think it's a great monitor for gaming. Really good contrast, really good blacks. I think you just have to calibrate it, but once you get calibrated, it performs really well. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and hope you enjoyed my little review. If you like it, like, subscribe, etc. Now, I wanted to test and see if I can hear that same crackling noise, you know, when the monitor shuts off, since it would cool down and parts are probably, you know, shrinking. And yes, you still can. I'm not sure if we'll pick it up on the video here, but that same creaking, crackling noise that was occurring when the monitor was warming up has the same effect when the monitor's cooling down. I don't know if this will occur for the lifetime of the product or if it's just an initial thing for a few days, but we'll keep monitoring this and let you guys know. Let's see if we can hear it. Yeah, definitely creak. Just wanted to say thank you guys for watching. If you liked the video, subscribe. If you didn't like it, subscribe and tell me why not. If there's anything I can improve, I would love to hear some feedback. Just write below in the comments section. Thank you guys for watching and hope you guys have a great rest of the day, weekend, whatever it is you're doing.
Since we're doing a comparison, I thought I would just compare the boxes for anyone that's interested. It is definitely a bit wider than the MSI box, but not only that, it's also longer. And that's obvious because the curve shortens the horizontal distance on the MSI. So we'll check out what's inside.